G'day, welcome back to Colecandoo. In this video, we'll have a look at the live preflight feature in Adobe InDesign. As a prepress operator, this tool is very useful in showing any prepress issues that files will have. However, I feel the way it's implemented in InDesign is too passive. In this episode, I'll show some tips and tricks to make it a more effective tool to generate press-ready artwork. Let's start with this travel flyer. My first issue with live preflight is where is it? So here's some thinking music. Have you found it? If you said here, then you've used preflight before. Now it says the profile is the basic profile and that there's no errors, right? Well, no. The basic profile is the default profile, and sadly it doesn't find a lot. To find out what it's checking for, go to the Preflight panel and select Define Profiles. The next issue is what's reported. Looking at the basic Preflight first, we can see it reports on links that are missing or modified, inaccessible URL links, overset text, font missing, and unresolved caption variables, but nothing else. Probably why it's called basic, right? No, nothing? Okay. Let's edit that and find missing glyphs as well. And again, a dialog appears saying that the basic profile can't be changed, but a new profile can be made. I'm going to cancel that and import some much more thorough settings. I do this by clicking the fly out and selecting Load Profile. And I'm going to load some heavy-duty settings that I downloaded earlier. The Flemish Innovation Centre for Graphic Communication, or VIGC for short, have made a collection of preflight profiles available from their website. But for non-Flemish speakers, I suggest using Google Chrome and using the Translate feature to get to the correct downloads page. The VIGC does have an English site, but at the time of shooting this video, the English downloading page was not working correctly. You'll be asked for your name and email. That's fine. The download will happen soon after this. Back to the import. Let's look at the preflight that I downloaded earlier from the VIGC. It's easy to see that this profile is checking far more thoroughly. To see how much more thorough the check is, I'll just have a go through these settings. So it's now checking for specific color issues, images and objects, and issues with the document as well. In a practical sense, to see how much more thorough the check is, let's change a setting to the VIGC profile. And now it says there are 16 errors. That's a lot for one page. And looking at the errors, it's possible to double click on them to tell me what's affected. So this will inspect this document using the more thorough preflight. But I want to make sure every document from this point onwards is using it. To do this, I'll close a file without saving it, navigate to my preflight panel, and go Preflight Options. In the new dialog box, I'd like to change a working profile to the more thorough one, the VIGC one. Now I have other options here, such as what layers to check, items on pasteboard, but for now I'm just going to change a working profile. But my biggest issue with live preflight is that despite having several errors in the document, I'm still able to print it and I'm still able to export it. That's fine if the document's in its infancy, but if this artwork were approved to print, there's nothing stopping a designer from submitting this as finished artwork. Until now. I've made a couple of startup scripts that act as a Preflight Enforcer. The first one is called Preflight Enforcer Strict, and here's why. Looking at the same document with the same Preflight, let's try exporting. I'll turn my Preflight off, close the panel, and try to export. Instead of the export PDF dialog box, I now receive an alert telling me that the document hasn't been preflighted. If I click OK, the alert closes, returning me to the document, while opening the preflight panel and turning on the thorough preflight for me. I'll try to export the PDF again. Notice that there's 16 errors. Now I get another error telling me that this artwork contains preflight errors and to resolve them using the preflight panel. Again, if I click OK, the alert closes and returns me to the document. Once again, opening the preflight panel. And no wonder it won't pass a preflight, it's using the thorough one. If I choose the basic one, there's no errors, it should pass. Right, let's try exporting again. Nope. By default, the script is looking for the preflight with the profile I've chosen. So choosing another preflight won't get around it. Guess I better fix the file. So through the magic of video editing, I've now fixed all the issues. The preflight says zero errors. So let's see if I can export it now. I can export it. So that's the first script. The second script is Preflight Enforcer Flexible. It works in a similar fashion to the first script, but warns rather than stops an export or print from happening. Using the original file, if my preflight checkbox is off, the dialog is closed, and I export, I'm warned about it, but I can still continue with the export. Likewise, the preflight checkbox is on and showing errors. I can export or print, but again, I'm warned that there are errors, but I can click past this and continue with the export. If you'd like to try these scripts, contact me via Colecandoo. Go to the contact button, fill out your name, your email. Understand that the scripts are in beta testing at the moment, and please read the instructions before using the scripts. My last issue with Preflight has to do with what it considers acceptable. Let's look at our document that has no preflight issues and is good to go, right? Not quite. If I turn my separations on, two graphics disappear. The London Calling graphic and the London Bus. They're meant to appear, so why has the preflight said that this is okay? Well, this is a behaviour of preflight. It's not a bug, as there's a variety of reasons a graphic may be on a non-printing layer or set to non-printing. Anyway, let's make sure this prints. If we check the layers panel, sure enough, there's one layer set to non-printing, as indicated by its name being in italics. We double-click it, and make sure that the print layer button is checked, and click OK. Should be good. Our London bus is still missing. But all the layers are now set to printing. And there's no option in the object menu to select non-printing. So how do I get this bus to print? Or how do I turn the non-printing off? Well, here's some thinking music. Found it? It's actually in the attributes panel. There's a non-printing checkbox. We need to turn it off. And now, everything's there. So ultimately, Preflight won't check for non-printing objects or layers, so be aware of this behavior. That's it for another video. If you got something out of this video, show me by hitting the like button and subscribe for more great videos. Check out Colecandoo or InDesign Secrets for the latest articles, or tweet me at Colecandoo. Until next time, I'll see you later.